As part of our commitment to sustainability, we're looking at new ways to bring innovative building practices to the Metro Tunnel project. Large construction projects use a lot of concrete, and the manufacturing of cement, the main ingredient in concrete, produces greenhouse gas emissions. By using recycled industrial byproducts instead, the Metro Tunnel project has managed to reduce its cement use by more than 50%, significantly reducing our carbon footprint. We're now turning our attention to the environmental impacts of another major ingredient of concrete, sand. While the smooth, round grains of sand found in deserts are plentiful, the angular, rough sand suitable for concrete is mostly mined or taken from rivers. It's become increasingly scarce and is being consumed at unsustainable rates. So we've set out to find a solution.
In collaboration with research and industry partners such as Cleanaway, Vortex Industries and Holcim, we have developed concrete mixes using crushed glass as the sand replacement in the construction of our temporary blinding works at Latrobe construction site of the new State Library station.
The process works like this. First, curbside waste glass is collected and broken down at this Cleanaway recycling facility. Next, the particles are dried and smashed even smaller using extreme whirlwinds at this Vortex processing plant. Then the product is screened to remove any remaining larger particles and impurities. What remains is ultra-fine glass sand. While it may sound relatively simple, there's some serious science driving the project. Here at the University of Melbourne, researchers are studying what processing glass this way does to its surface chemistry, particle size and shape, and how to optimise concrete mixes when glass is used instead of sand. In the lab, test concrete is put through durability compliance tests to help prove it's strong enough for use in infrastructure projects.
The idea was to have a systematic process in place to have glass processed for large-scale concrete production so that it can be used for structural concrete. We are not aware of any similar work done anywhere else in Australia or in the world.
Here at the Metro Tunnel Project's Holcim batching plant, the glass sand is mixed into concrete in lieu of conventional sand. It's then transported to State Library Station, where it's used to create temporary slabs that are used to prepare for the permanent slab structure.
By providing a field trial site for this innovative research, we're hoping that we can pave the way for full-scale commercialisation of recycled glass in structural concrete.
Now and for the future, it's just one way we're helping develop environmentally friendly construction practices on Victoria's Big Build.